I think the public have a negative perception of the people in Parliament because, like, the press, you don't hear positive stories about us. It's always negative about people lying in their beds and sitting up to hours, not got to work and fighting all the time. It does happen, I'm not going to lie, but it's like a minority. People who's in who are on remand or whatever are doing short sentences. They just want to go in, they lie about laziness and want to get back out. The boys who's doing a sentence, man, I want to get stuck in, learn something.
I think what a lot of people see is maybe the mistakes they've made. What's invisible is the real positive change, and I think that's a shame because there's so much unrealised potential that these young men have.
They've come in with the milks at 7 in the morning at your door, so I was usually up there and get a milk. Make a coffee, but that time it's about 7:30. The work parties leave at 8:15, so go to my work party then. Go to the gym in the afternoon, get a shower, get my dinner, then you get recreation at night, go out and play pool with your pals, and then just back in at 8:15 for dub up. That's it to the next morning.
That's a myth. You can't be lazy in the jail. You're up at 7 o'clock every morning and you're getting your breakfast and you're getting ready and you go to your work party or you go to education or you do something like that. I work for the radio in here, so I'm got to go out there and do an engineering course, like sound set up and stuff like that. What you'll find is a lot of the boys in here are really, really hard workers, you know what I mean? They just haven't been given a chance.
Since I've been here, I've done my hairdressing SVQs, my paint and decking SVQs, doing a gym instructor's course now, doing a gym.
I've done like young enterprise, starting businesses and that, like gaining confidence, man, public speaking, doing the different work parties, like learning new skills. Go up at youth work, I've done different groups up there you can do. Just learning how to kind of calm yourself down, go up, there's like drop-ins in that day, just go up and meet new people, sit and socialise. I've seen a lot of people just coming in and out all the time, and I don't want to do, I want to go out, make a bit of money, get on my feet, man, and sort my life out.
I know once I go there and somebody gives me that one chance, I'll be grabbing that with two hands and I won't be letting it go. So hopefully once they get back out there, somebody does give me a chance and I can just prove to my family and prove to everybody else that I'm not the same person as I was when I came in.
A lot of the young men that we work with in the youth work service will get involved in the prison, they'll get involved in activities, they'll engage with programmes. We've got young men who do fundraising, they've raised money for different charities of their choice. And they leave here much better skilled, much, you know, a lot more qualifications. And that black mark that they had still sort of follows them. If employers had a wee bit of an insight into what it's like in here, I think they'll be a lot more likely to give one of these young men a chance.
A lot of young offenders in the prison actually do a lot of good stuff. Aye, they've done stupid stuff to get themselves in the jail in the first place, but once they're here, you know what I mean, people actually take part in productive activities and it is quite a positive experience in a way.
Well, what a day stuff. There's a lot of boys who's up and are willing to do, who's willing to work and better themselves.
They can get up in the morning, they can go to work. That they're motivated to go there and might not come back. It might even be because they gave them a chance that they might not be back to prison because they've got a job to go to.
For a lot of these young people, we're closing more doors than opening them. And we're not really giving our young people a second chance. And I think it's vitally important that they are given a second chance, even a third chance.
My sentence was 5 years, 2 months. Before I went in, I wouldn't have thought about doing dance. And I wasn't that keen on doing it. I'd done the first day and I really enjoyed it, so I went back. I stayed in touch with the teacher, I wrote her a letter asking her, telling her I'd wanted to do dance for my work placement. Before I got out and before I got my work placement, I didn't think I was going to get a chance. If I never had the opportunity that I've had, I would have been homeless, stuck on the dole. I wouldn't have got out for good behaviour. I'd just be a mess. Quite a scary thought.